love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. We have come together to witness the marriage of Hal and Brittany, to pray God's blessing on them, to share their joy, and to celebrate their love. Man and woman grow together in love and trust. They shall be united with one another in heart, body and mind, as Christ is united with his bride, the Church. The gift of marriage brings husband and wife together. Take you, Brittany.
I, Hal, take you, Brittany.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have
and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
To death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
I, Brittany, take you, Hal.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God.
And in the presence of God, I made this vow.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
With my body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
Most of the stuff, all that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. That's tight. I don't want to hurt them.
This ring
as a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body I honour you.
With my body I honour you.
All that I am I give to you.
All that I am I give to you.
And all that I have I share with you.
And all that I have I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son and Holy Spirit.
In the presence of God and before this congregation, Hal and Brittany have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Hal, you may now kiss your wife.
Thank you.
Thank you. afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Having never been the father of a bride before, and how to prepare this speech, I turned to our old friend Google for a bit of advice. Now, when I opened up the page, there came this list of do's and don'ts. Quite a long list, to be perfectly honest with you. So much so, by the time I'd read it, I thought, what's the bloody point? So here's just a few of those things that I read. And the first one was, don't embarrass the bride, your daughter. It's her day. Good advice. Second one, don't poke fun at your new son-in-law, ridicule him, unless he's of a mind that he understands you.
Good advice. Good advice.
Number three, don't give them any marital advice. Don't be a marriage guidance counsellor, because your friends and family might not agree with you. It's a personal thing. Number four, and I thought this was quite good, this is fair enough. When you're talking to your guests, make sure they understand that you are speaking on behalf of yourself and your wife or your partner. So, with that in mind, I thought, well, that's good advice. Because at the end of the day, marriage is about sharing, it's about 50-50, as they say. So if I make an absolute cock-up of this speech, Paul, half of it's your fault. If you can make them laugh, then you're halfway there. And keep it short, so thanks very much. So that's the structure. So basically, this is what I put together. On behalf of Mark, Lynn, Paul, and myself, welcome to Home Farm. Sorry, Stud Farm. Perhaps you'd like to check your invitations, you might be at the wrong bloody wedding. But yeah, listen, thanks guys for coming. Some of you have travelled a long way to be with us all today to share this very special day with us all. At this point, I'd just like to say just a small pause in reflection of people that may not be able to be with us today. I could stand up here all afternoon and tell you and thank you all for things that you've done and name individuals, but I'm going to really condense it down to one big one. Without all the people that have helped us along the way to get to where we are, I thank you on behalf of all of us for all your help and commitment. Thank you very much indeed. I would like also just especially to thank Hal and his dad and their friends for building this barn, which has took a...
Don't worry. It might fall down yet. Don't worry. Bloody ham. Quick.
Which is basically...
Get out. Honestly.
For building the barn.
It's not
basically
spare even Risa.
To create this atmosphere of this rural countryside theme that they wanted for their wedding day. And at this point, I would like to welcome Hal to the family on behalf. Well, we would like to welcome, firstly as a son-in-law, secondly as a member of the family, and thirdly, mate, a friend. Welcome, Hal.
No problem.
Who's this shaking me out?
I've had your watch off, you're alright.
It's only a Casio, don't worry about it.
Now, bring it up, kids. Basically, this is a little bit of time, just a little short trip in my life and our lives of how we sort of thought about bringing up kids. But as a young lad growing up in my family, you know, working and waiting for my dad to come home from work and doing things in the garden, the cars, cutting the grass, waiting for granddad to come just to dig the garden so it got dirty so mum didn't send me to Sunday school, all them little bits and pieces. And then holiday time was always very special. Cornwall, caravans, the camping, rounders on the camping field, surfing, the swimming, all those sort of things down in Cornwall. I know that Cornwall holds a special place in Hal's childhood and whatever upbringing. We did all those things, and I think that Paul and I have passed all of that on to Sarah and to Stephanie, wherever Stephanie is, where are you? There you are. We've done all those things, but we've also done other things. We've run together, we've run in Southport, we've run in Market Drayton, we've run in Abersock. We've done all those sort of things. Sarah's still playing rounders and captain of a rounders team. And all these things that I look at what we've done and they've rubbed off. I like to think they've rubbed off and they've created these people that they are today. And Vera, I mean, you're an avid knitter. Old and knitter.
I'm not
a knitter, although I've stitched a few people up. Sarah and Stephanie have like taken up the crochet stuff, and like some of the things that Sarah and Stephanie crocheted were totally unrecognisable. I mean, unrecognisable. But now they got these little things. They've done, and in all fairness,
what are they?
Well, that's you. But yeah, I mean, that's all part of the makeup. But then, I mean, I know this is Brittany's day, so now we swing on to this young lady here. Brittany's the son that I probably didn't get. Like me, she'd rather have rugby than football. We like Land Rovers, evidently. She can burp like the rest of us.
Yes, she can.
She can. Oh, there's another page here, but anyway, let's just turn this over. This might be a bit of a mystery. Yeah, she likes Land Rovers. She can hold her corner when it comes to a pint of Guinness.
Yes, she can.
She can. She can. And then when she was sort of 16, she wanted to come shooting, and I introduced her to shooting with Bob Valentine, and she soon got into the hang of that and became confident and very safe and met some lovely people out there in our shooting friends. People are over there in the bottom corner. Nice to see you guys here today. She's been like a shooting partner with me. So from the beach to the shooting field and today to this beautiful... Get your kisses ready, guys. This beautiful young lady that I've just given away. My dad used to say, Take your time. Dad used to have a loads of those little sayings, but we all use them. There's no smoke without fire, there's no this, that, and the other. There's all sorts of things. Rolling stones gather no moss. But the one he used to say, and I think it's very poignant today, apples never fall far from the tree. On top of that, guys, they've just had this beautiful young little man here, our first grandchild. You really have got, you've got it perfect, guys. You have got absolutely spot on. Whatever you found in each other when you met each other, however you fell in love, whatever, you were the people you were, how you were, and obviously what you've done, evidently. you couldn't have got it better. We're very proud as grandparents. And somebody said to me not so long back, what's it like being a granddad? I said, it's fantastic. I've only been granddad a few weeks. Oh, what are you going to be called? Granddad Steve? Granddad? Grandpa? I don't know. I don't think it's really... Paul's grandma will...
No, you're not.
Check. Mama Paul. Don't forget that, guys. Please, thank you. Mama Paul. So they said, what do you like best about being a granddad? I said, waking up with his grandmother. I've had some really good times as a kid growing up, and this is my last little bit of a story here. And it's all these things that you build up and you think that you've like passed it on to all of them. But I can remember going back when I was 7 years old, there's a man in this room that a good friend of mine, Mick Sutton, down the bottom there. Mick.
Go on, Mick.
We were at school together, me and Mick. And when he was 7 years old, he lived in that flat down Shropshire Street at Point House. And we had a birthday party for him. Lovely mum and dad, Laura and Richard. And we went to his birthday party, my mother got me dressed up, new shorts on, just nipped me a new mustard cardi. Bobby Dazzler, absolute cracking. So he gets to the front door. She says, you behave yourself. Bring your manners, Mr. and Mrs. Sutton. Yeah, okay, mum. Open the door, all my mates there, bang, wallop, we're off. Go in, we went round, chasing your sister around the living room, over the sofa, jelly, bloody ice cream everywhere. Then his mother come in and she said, Michael, just calm it down. So he said, yeah, all right. Sofa been over. Blamed that on Andrew Pawley because he was fatter than us. Then your dad come through, didn't he? You remember your dad come through? He just went, hey. And walked off, confiscated his sister and walked off. That was it, job done. Mick, they were good days. I'll always remember it. There are lots of stuff that I remember. And it's just... those are the sort of things and those little stories that you pass on to to the kids, and we hope that you've got a foundation to build your lives on, kids. So I've got no more to say other than, please, charge your glasses. Be upstanding with me to wish the health, the wealth and the future success to these wonderful people, to Hal, to Brittany and to young Finn.
Cheers, jockey!
I've known Al for about 16 years or so. When I first saw him in Chesapeake, I thought he was M&M in a person's house. After meeting with him and spending a lot of time together, we got to know each other pretty well. I'll never forget the time we saw an ad in the paper about someone selling cheap Chinese motorbikes in Birmingham. Hal and I, being us, shot over to Birmingham in rather a small Peugeot 306, met up with a chap and bought two of these bikes. I asked Hal, how the bloody hell do you reckon we're going to get these into the back of this car? Hal being Hal, wedged the two into the back of the car. Boot to boot, off the door, boot wide open, and off the market drain we went. After assembling these bikes, we went out for hours and hours, for miles and miles. That day was a brilliant day that I will never forget. However, this was a bit false economy with the bikes that we had given, that we had bought. We gave them that much stick, ending up costing a fortune in back tyres, inner tubes, and bending the cheap metal. I have many stories that I could tell you and go on and on.
No, don't tell me. No, don't. Bloody hell, how do you say cheap Chinese monkey metal? Not even if I answer that.
About the countless good times and memories that we've had together. But unfortunately, I'm going to have to start wrapping this up now. But I'm currently typing it up on the computer. Me and computers do not get on that, as you're aware. You only have the groom to blame. As you can see, we had a mishap regarding the UTV vehicle and Hal's terrible driving a couple of days ago. But all round, he's a good lad, honest, trustworthy, generous and helpful. Terrible bloody timekeeper. But all round, a good lad. Serious note, Hal has been a brilliant friend over the years and truly an honour to be his best man. We have had some excellent times together and I know we'll have many more to continue. So I would like to wish Hal and Brittany together and Finn a happy marriage and a wonderful life together. So ladies and gentlemen, please, raise the glass. Mr. and Mrs. Teeson.
Said, right, I do apologise, I'm last minute, so I'm not going to speak to you. I'm not wrote anything. I thought about it for a couple of days, but... Written, sorry. There you go, see, that's right. I'd like to thank Brittany. I better thank Brittany first, yes. My beautiful bride.
What?
I want you to make it carry on. I'd also like Mark and Polly, thank you very much for everything you've done or put on.
Thank you.
And Mum and Dad for everything they've done or put on, obviously at home. But the bridesmaids, you look pretty dog. I was going to say dog right, but... you're right, sorry, I mean pretty, sorry. I was going to say pretty dog rough, John. No, you're very good, though. I'd like to thank Pitchy. Not Jockey, he did nothing. Honestly, he did nothing. He milked it. I got Bill. Eggs on the tongue. Who? Great Wayne Rooney. He's at the back there. No, I'd like to thank Pitchy, Solly and Tech, because they've done a lot. Jockey did. Jack shit. Pete, cheers for giving him a lift. Thank you very much. Leave the 90 here. And the 110, I'll take the keys. But I'd just like to thank you all for coming to join the special day with us. And raise a glass to my beautiful wife.
Stand by me. steady. Do you want some chicha? Are you ready for shaker? Are you ready for skater?
You got to get down, baby.
him sniping for breakfast. So I heard a rainbow can be fair. Oh, 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 oh. Wife and the kids in front of my baby. Now that she said I was yours to be seen. Oh, 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 oh. Is her life, your country naked? Sure did I hear up from the day I'm on. No one wants to end up like money in the crowd. Who knows, who knows, who knows? Is her life, listen to the man.